Get ready to match the stars from MASH, Jerry Burghoff, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Meg Bennett, Richard Dawson, and Fannie Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77.
Thank you very much. Well, they're beautiful, and so are you. Nice to see all of you.
You're very nice looking, too.
Doesn't he look great?
Yeah. He's got a mustache, and he won the Emmy and everything.
Yes, congratulations to you.
They have no connection. Thank you.
Yes, they do. You suppose if you grew a mustache, you could get an Emmy, too?
You never can tell. Should I try?
Yeah.
Okay.
She wouldn't get a nomination with a beard, even.
A three.
Now, we have no barbs or slings for you because we're happy to see you once again.
Thank you.
And you, too.
Thank you, sir.
And you, my dear.
Thank
you. How are you?
I'm fine. I want to thank the Academy for the award I got. It wasn't on television, unfortunately. It was a Purple Heart Award for sharing a dressing room with Brett Summers. And I thank you.
All right. Let's say hello to our two players, Deborah Clodio and Rick Engstrom. Where are we here? Oh, we finished round one. What is that? We finished round one, right? And each of you matched one of our celebrities. And now we're going to start with round two here. Now, this lady's a current champ. She's only won $200. And she's going along there like Old Man River, and she's got a whole bunch of junk in front of her here.
Those are from each one of my kids.
What's that?
They're good luck charms from each one of my kids.
Oh, well, that's nice. I forgot how many kids you have.
Five,
that's it. One, two, three, four, five. Five kids, huh? Okay, now, Rick here, would you refresh our memories about where you're from, please?
Yeah, I'm a police officer, city of Los Angeles. Been with them for 9 years.
Okay, all right. All right, we'll start round two. Now, this is the final round, and we'll have a winner in a moment or so, but right now we've got to do a little business with America. Here we go. Second and final round. Rick, you may have A or B.
I'll take B.
B it is. Everyone except Brett will play, right?
Did I match?
You matched in the previous round.
What came over me?
I don't know. You had a lapse. Harry said to Fred, when you told me that my blind date was a tomato, I thought it was because she was pretty, not because she had a big red blank.
Oh, I like that.
When you told me my blind date was a tomato, I thought it was because she was pretty, not because she had a big red blank.
Do you know how I matched?
How?
I wasn't here. Somebody else was in the seat.
No, no one occupied that seat. All right. Have you been thinking about it, Rick?
Yes, sir.
All right, we're ready for you, Rick. Harry said to Fred, when you told me that my blind date was a tomato, I thought it was because she was pretty, not because she had a big red...
nose.
Big red nose. Now, wait a minute. I ask you, if you don't like nose, what do you like? What? You don't know what you like there. What do you like, Gary?
I have one nose for L.A.'s finest.
There you go. One nose for Rick. And Charles, he's looking for a nose.
On the nose.
On the nose. Now he's got three. You remember how this goes, Meg. You got the hang of it last time, didn't you?
I think I did. I said nose.
Well, you got the hang of it this time, too. Then you see, man, my blind date was a tomato. I thought it was because she was pretty, not because she had a big red...
I hope you won't, start following him around on a motorcycle. I said no.
You said no, that's right. That's fine. And now?
Yes.
The bad news, Rick.
The bad news. No, this little girl was in heaven, and they were giving out noses. She thought they said roses. She says, give me a big red one.
A big red one.
Yeah.
Deborah, you have to go to work now.
and match five remaining celebrities to achieve a tie and stay in the game, and that's the best you can do here. Gary, if you would please, sir, would you not participate this time?
Did I match before?
You matched before.
See, I didn't even know it.
Yes, right, and you weren't even here.
I know.
You did it by remote control. Here we go. At the restaurant, Harvey said to the waiter,
yeah?
These steaks are so much like rubber, they have blank stamped on them. Okay. Waiting for Brett and Chuck. Deborah, think about it. Get a little ESP from your kids or from our celebrities. That's what you want.
Come along, dear.
At the restaurant, Harvey said to the waiter, these steaks are so much like rubber, they have blank stamped on them.
Breakable.
What?
Breakable. I can't think of anything.
You really didn't listen to it. Oh, Deborah, you must listen carefully. All right, Brett, you are first. Got to match everybody.
These steaks taste so much like rubber, they have Goodyear stamped
on. Goodyear! So that means Rick wins the game. What do you have? Goodyear, Goodyear, Goodyear. They all have Goodyear. Okay, Rick, if you'll just stand on the little blue spot in the rug there, we'll say goodbye to Deborah and wish her well. I'm glad you're not leaving here empty-handed.
No.
And your kids will love the fact that you want some money. Deborah Clodio, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being with us. Goodbye. While we're spinning her off, we'll spin these messages just for you. How do you feel?
Great.
Yeah. Rick Engstrom here has won his first game. He has $100, but now he has a chance at a real bundle of money. He could win over $5,000 here, Rick. Here it is. It's all yours, this big money super match. Not too long ago, we had a bunch of people in this room, and we polled them. We put a questionnaire to them. We said, write down your best answer to this. The March blank. The March blank. Now, the answer they wrote down most frequently will get you $500 if you match it. If you decide to choose their second most popular answer, you get $250 and $100 for matching their third answer, and three of our six celebrities will help.
First of all, Richard Dawson.
The March Hare.
The March Hare.
Sure.
The March
Alice,
Hare.
Don't you like him?
Right.
You said,
yeah, sure. Indeed, I love the March Hare. I love all the characters of Alice in Wonderland. The audience is thrilled with your answer, too.
We're not concerned.
The reason you can't hear the audience is the ovation was deafening, Rich, you see. And for a moment there, you lost your hearing.
Just
you couldn't
a second,
hear.
I'll make a note of that. Clear audience by tomorrow.
Yes.
Okay.
Brett?
What about the March of Dimes?
Yeah. Well, Betty White's going to be very upset.
I didn't hear that one either, did you?
No, it's deadly quiet.
Was there a noise there?
Gary.
What she said. No, the March of Time.
The March of Time. So there you have three. Yeah, the March of Time. Oh, he used to say, time marches on. And then you got the March of Dimes, and you have the March Hare.
I'll take the March of Dimes.
The March of Dimes, lucky that. Let's go to this big board now and begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. The March Hare is
aren't you ashamed? Rabbits for everybody.
Right. See, it was up there. And now we'll reveal the $250 response, the March of Time. All right, last chance now for the March of Dimes. Here we go. Slide it, please. Yes, you got it. Congratulations. Very good. She's a good hugger and squeezer, isn't she?
Fantastic.
You sounded like a teenager. Fantastic. When you were up there hugging and squeezing, I saw the... that's a wallet. That's the biggest wallet.
Honey, people are going to take your hand off that man's blank.
No, but...
Since
he's a member of
the
New
vice
York... Since he's a member of the police department, I thought he came here with a holster on. You're not packing a rod, are you?
I'm amongst friends.
Oh, all right. Thank
That's
you.
What you think.
Now, Rick... You won the $500. You'll play for 10 times that amount now, or $5,000, and we'll give you the money gladly if you'll match one celebrity. Now, this has to be an exact match.
Reliable Richard Dawson.
All right, here we go. Reliable Richard. All reliable Richard. Dawson. You ready, Rich?
Yes, sir.
Here we go. Good luck to you. Get your ESP going over to him. Here it is. It reads as follows. Blank Bible. Blank Bible. All right, Rick. Give us the answer that he has already written and put in the slot in that card, and we give you $5,000.
Holy Bible.
Holy Bible. All right.
Well,
the members of the Gideon Society are cheering very loudly out there. What did you say, Rich? He says,
you
holy Bible.
I live in motels and hotels all over the country.
Well,
and
the Gideons.
Every drawer, they have the...
Holy Bible. You got friends here?
I have my best friend here, my wife.
Your best friend and your wife is here? Where is she? She is very, very, very happy. There she is. Well, congratulations to you, and congratulations to Rick Engstrom. And now is a total of $5,600, and he's going to meet a new challenger now. Here comes Carol Cruz. There's your souvenir card for you. Hello there, Carol. All right, anytime you want to climb aboard the carousel, you can. We'll welcome Carol Cruz and tell her how happy we are to see her and ask her to tell us a little bit about herself.
Well, I'm a clerk typist for the city of Los Angeles, and I was recently married to a Los Angeles police officer.
No kidding.
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever heard of him before?
No.
Before you met backstage here?
No.
No. And does your husband work anywhere near where he works?
No, he works someplace else.
I see. How long have you been married, Carol?
Since June.
Since June?
Mm-hmm.
July, August.
Okay, Carol. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
We'll begin by asking you to make a decision. You may have A or B.
B, please.
All right. She wants B, and she got it. Gloria said, I am a very successful traveling sales lady because instead of selling door to door, I sell my wares blank to blank.
What is that?
Gloria said, I'm a very successful sales lady because instead of selling my wares door to door, I sell my wares blank to blank.
All over. He doesn't need to know.
How's the trout farm?
Terrific.
Good.
18 inches.
No kidding.
Last one I caught. The trout, I mean.
Delicious fish I've ever had was in his house. Absolutely terrific. Here we go, Carol. Gloria said, I am a very successful traveling sales lady because instead of selling door to door, I sell my wares blank to blank.
Person to person?
Person to person. Instead of selling door to door, you see, that would be person to person because a person would come to the door.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's all right. You can borrow your husband's gun and do a little breaking and entering if you don't win anything here. Okay, Gary, she says person to person.
At first, I couldn't think of any answer, and then I heard that devilish little way you read that card, and
I
heard the snicker from the audience, and then I went like this, and I said bed to bed.
Which is in itself an interesting phenomenon, because that's what I said.
Interesting. We have two of those. You're getting the hang of it now, aren't you, Carol? All right. Hello, Chuck.
You ever sit all day with Ella Raines and Adolph Manjou? You can go nuts.
Adolph Manjou.
Bed to bed.
Okay. All right. This lady sells her wares bed to bed. What do you say to that, Meg?
I say bed to bed.
Oh, wouldn't this have been a big winner for you, Carol, if you had said it? What do you say?
Yeah, well, being a newlywed, that's what I thought. You know, she
right.
would have said.
Yeah. Matter of fact, I was wondering why she was doing on this show if she's only been married 4 months. Hello there.
Hello there.
How are you?
Fine. I'm sorry. I had bed to bed.
Oh, sorry. There it is. Six bed to beds there. Well, that's the way it goes. Rick will have a question for you in a moment or so, but right now we've got this for you. Hello. Hello, hello. All right. You ready, Rick?
Yes, sir.
First rounder. Remember, they're a little tougher. She had a little trouble with hers. Let's see how you do with yours.
They're slippery, too.
Yeah, they're slippery, right? Fat Frida was such a fat baby, she wasn't delivered by a stork. She was delivered by a blank. Fat Frida. Fat Baby.
Don't look.
Don't look. I'm not looking.
No, him.
Oh, him.
You know who him is, don't
yes.
you?
Okay, Rick, here it is. Fat Frida was such a fat baby, she wasn't delivered by a stork. She was delivered by a blank.
By a crane.
A crane. Delivered by a crane.
Gene Crane is a better
Gene fact. Crane, yes. yes.
No, I'm sorry. He's had the right answer, I think.
Yeah,
I said blimp.
Blimp would be good. Well, remember in first round...
Oh, same to you, fella.
There are a number of possibilities for first rounders. What do you say?
I thought a crane and a stork were about the same. They're not?
No.
It's a crane? Oh, shucks. I'm sorry. I had the wingspread of an albatross.
An albatross. Yeah, that's
they
stronger,
have like a...
stronger than a stork. Yes.
You kids don't know about bites.
Right.
About bites.
What did you say?
I said the crane, which fingernails are smaller than the flamingo.
Wasn't delivered by a stork, was delivered by a...
crane.
Crane for him. All right.
Yeah, after 6 years of Hogan's Heroes, I once swore this word would never pass my lips, but crane.
Oh, such fond memories he has. Hello there.
Hi, hon.
You gonna open your...
No, it was just embarrassing to sit with the winning group and come up with the answer. I thought she was delivered by a truck.
A truck, hey. Okay, so you picked up two cranes there, and the score at the end of round one is 2-0 in favor of the champ.
Three.
Oh, yes, that's right. He had one before, so it's 3-0.
The first experience.
All right. Thank you very much for being so alert, all of you. All right, Carol, you got a choice again of A or B.
B again.
B again. B again.
B again.
Bernard said, I think my wife is having an affair with old man Periwinkle.
Oh. Oh.
Good gravy, Marie.
And I'll tell you why I think so. Last night, she came home with blank on her breath.
Oh, I got it.
You got it.
I got it.
You got it.
Don't look. I don't got it.
You don't got it? No, that's a very it. Easy one. I think my wife is having an affair with old man Periwinkle. You know who?
Yeah, I know who he is. I've done
last night, she
up.
Came home with blank on her breath.
That mustache has impeded his thinking power.
Yeah, he does. I like it. It makes him
like nothing is impeding my thinking yeah. power. I've always been dumb.
It gives him that Ronald Coleman look, doesn't it?
Yeah, sure
Thank
does.
Thank you very much. I really enjoyed doing this show.
Okay. Carol Cruz, you ready?
Yes.
Here we go. Bernard said, I think my wife is having an affair with old man Periwinkle. Last night she came home with blank on her breath.
Geritol?
Geritol! Rick likes your answer. They like your answer. Let's see if the celebrities like your answer.
I said false teeth.
Was stretching a little. Now listen.
Now, we won't take the Emmy away from you, but, yes.
There might be geritol on it.
Spray a little rust on it, that's
No,
all.
It'll turn green.
Sure. I said, oh, for heaven's sakes, I said geritol.
Geritol is the answer. That little lady wants. A little geritol for the lady, Chuck?
Yo, sure, babe.
Okay. I know she doesn't look as if she needs it, but give her a little geritol.
Okay.
All right, she's got a little geritol.
I was going to say Polident, but I said geritol.
Oh, important to her. Now, Fannie, give her some geritol. Stop fooling around.
All right. Geritol.
Okay.
Thank you.
And now here we are in the middle of round two. It's 5-3, and you've got a little work cut out for you, Rick, and we'll see how it turns out after we see about this. I thought we'd have time to carry on, but we don't. We'll have to pick this up where we left off next time. Middle of round two, score is 5-3 in favor of the challenger, and we'll look forward to seeing you both next time. And you, too, will look forward to seeing next time there. Any parting shots before we go?
My friend B. Arthur won the Emmy, too.
Oh, she did, yes.
I cried because I was so glad.
Were you there?
No, I was sitting home going, oh! I thought I died and gone to that other place.
Yes, it's a little quiet, isn't it? Join us next time for Match Game 77. I'm Gene Rayburn. Tally ho!